Wall Street is awaiting a slightly higher open on Friday. Economic data and earnings are providing a hefty breakfast ahead of the opening bell. U.S. retail sales for the latest month rebounded by 1.6%. Car sales and higher gas prices in the wake of hurricanes boosted those figures. And more inflation figures came out this morning, and we did see CPI, the headline figure, as well as the monthly and annualized rate come in slightly below expectations. Now, in the previous session, U.S. indices closed lower, pressured by shares in the telecom services, media, autos and component sectors. 43% of S&P 500 constituents traded lower yesterday. Now, moving on to company news, Wells Fargo missed on Q3 revenue as results were hammered by a one-time charge. Earnings beat forecasts, but revenue came in at $21.93 billion below estimates. The company is struggling to recover from a consumer sales scandal. And moving on to Bank of America, the company beat forecasts in terms of earnings. EPS came in at 48 cents, while revenue came in at $22.07 billion. The bank's fixed income trading revenue fell 22% on a year-over-year basis. In terms of overseas markets, Asian markets were mostly higher, with the Nikkei up nearly 1%, the Hang Seng flat, and South Korea's Kospi flat as well. European indices are trading flat on Friday. Here in the U.S., the S&P 500 is in the spotlight. The bullish buy stands above 2545, with long positions at that above that level, preferred with targets standing at 2553.50. And 2558 in extension. As for the Nasdaq, the upside prevails, and for the Dow Industrials, the bias remains bullish.